Hi everyone, my name is Ravtopoul Athina, and today I'm going to present a work which is co-authored with my colleague from the University of Patras, Professor Nicolas Giannakopoulos. The paper is entitled The Health Effect of Worker Flows, Evidence from Greece, and let's start a bit with the background of this work. There is a huge literature on the role of unemployment in shaping individual health, while there are several studies that focus on observing this relationship within periods of well-defined microeconomic downturns. With a view to shed light in this relationship, we estimate the effect of unemployment on self-assessed health using the relevant case of Greece, which was one of the hardest hit countries during the Great Recession, mainly focusing on worker transitions to unemployment and their effect on health. Looking at this graph, we see that as unemployment increases, worsening health increases as well for the case of Greece, which serves as a motivation for revealing the exact mechanism of this relationship, especially during the years of economic downturn. For the purposes of our analysis, we use data from the EU CILIC survey, and this database contains both cross-sectional and longitudinal information on individual and household data of individuals aged more than 16 years old. Our analysis, in fact, differentiates in that it is based on the effect of employment status transitions rather than the current economic activity status alone. So using this data, we are aware of the health status of individuals even before their unemployment episodes actually start, which is an important advantage over cross-sectional data sources that have been more frequently used in similar analysis. For the purpose of the analysis, we only use individuals between 16 and 54 years old in order to fade out issues of the retirement process, and also we exclude the ones with health problems. This analysis uses as a dependent variable measures for health. The first one is self-assessed health, and the second one is health deterioration. Self-assessed health takes values from 1 to 5, 5 indicating poor health, and health deterioration is a binary variable based on self-assessed health defined as a transition from a better health status to worse health. Moving to the independent variables that we use, the main variable of interest is the one corresponding on the employment status transition. In all our models, we further adjust for age, sex, marital status, Greek nationality, and income in logs. We start by performing a probit model to estimate the effect of employment status deterioration on health deterioration, and then we go on with a difference in differences approach to identify any causal links, and here we use only the worst 2-year period of the crisis, which is 2012 and 2013. We provide two specifications for this approach that differentiate in terms of the group of the treated individuals. Treatment one corresponds to the group of individuals that have been continuously employed during 2012, but then lose their jobs and stay unemployed for all 12 months of the following year. Treatment two corresponds to the group of individuals that have been continuously employed during 2012, but then lost their jobs and stayed unemployed at least 7 months of the following year. The second group aims to control for the individuals who have seasonal contracts. Moving on with the third step, we also use a difference in differences propensity score matching approach to get rid of selection bias by conditioning on confounding variables. Moving to the results of the analysis, we see in table one the estimates of the probit model. Most results are expected, and importantly, employment status deterioration is significant and positively associated with health deterioration, meaning that the ones that have experienced a deterioration in terms of their employment status are indeed more likely to experience health deterioration. For the difference in differences analysis, as I said before, we use monthly information on the employment status of the individuals. We also split by gender to see how these results differentiate. We see that unemployment negatively affects health with the same magnitude for both specifications, with the results mainly being driven by women, as we see from the table. The DID PSM results also show an important increase in self-assessed health with exposure to unemployment using the period 2012-2013. To wrap up, if we were to single out some takeaway points of this analysis, we could say that the ones that experience a deterioration in terms of their employment status report worse health, and that we have evidence that an employment transition causally impairs health during periods of economic distress, which is a result that is mostly driven by women. We saw that recession has a detrimental effect on health for everyone, but the effect is larger for the ones that become unemployed. And also from the DID PSM results, we also see an important increase in self-assessed health with exposure to unemployment. Thank you very much for your attention, and please feel free to share your comments on this presentation.